Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss chemical properties of non-metals. First thing is, what are non-metals? Non-metals are those elements which have either 5, 6 or 7 electrons in their valence shell. Means they can gain or attract electrons and they form a negatively charged ions. Means anions. Right? So, chemistry of non-metals is slightly differ from metals. So, now we are going to discuss reactions of non-metals with various compounds. First is reaction with oxygen. Non-metals react with oxygen to form their oxides respectively. For example, we have carbon plus oxygen to give CO2 plus heat. Energy is released in this reaction. So we can say this is an exothermic reaction. What is this now? This is carbon dioxide. For example, we have sulfur dioxide. Sulfur catches fire when exposed to air. SO2 gas burns with the fire. Right? But if we supply oxygen in less amount, deficiency of oxygen is there, less supply, instead of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide is formed, and this is a poisonous gas. Right? Now these oxides are acidic in nature. So non-metal oxides are acidic in nature, so means they can react with the base. If we react non-metal oxide with NaOH, this is acid, this is base. So reaction will take place between acid and base. What will happen? Sodium carbonate is formed plus water is formed. It is again a type of salt formation, acid plus base to form salt and water. Right? If we pass CO2 from calcium hydroxide, calcium carbonate is formed plus water is released. So non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. They will convert blue litmus to red. Metal oxides are basic, but non-metal oxides are acidic. So this is reaction of acid with the base. Right? Even non-metal oxides react with the water to form salt. CO2 plus water to form carbonic acid. Sulfur dioxide reacts with the water to form sulfurous acid. Sulfur dioxide reacts with water to form sulfurous acid. Sulfuric acid may be formed, but the condition will be different. SO2 first react with the oxygen to form sulfur trioxide. Now this sulfur trioxide reacts with water to form sulfuric acid. Right? So non-metal oxides react with base as well as with the water to form their acids. Next is reaction with the chlorine. For example, we have phosphorus plus chlorine. It will form its क्लोराइड, नॉन मेटल क्लोराइड, एक वी कैन बैलेंस इट राइट फॉर व्हेन H2 रिएक्ट्स विद क्लोरीन हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड राइट रिएक्शन विद द क्लोरीन. नेक्स्ट इज रिएक्शन विद हाइड्रोजन. नॉन मेटल रिएक्ट विद हाइड्रोजन टू फॉर्म कोवलेंट हाइड्राइड. मीन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन विल शेयर बिटवीन नॉन मेटल एंड हाइड्रोजन. दैट्स व्हाई कोवलेंट हाइड्राइड इज फॉर्म्ड. फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव नाइट्रोजन प्लस हाइड्रोजन टू फॉर्म अमोनिया राइट. कंडीशन ऑफ अमोनिया फॉर्मेशन इज दिस रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ आयरन एंड मॉलिब्डेनम. आयरन एक्ट एज ए कैटलिस्ट. कैटलिस्ट इज अ डेड सब्सटेंस व्हिच हेल्प्स इन द रिएक्शन. मींस इंक्रीज द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. फॉर एग्जांपल ऑक्सीजन रिएक्ट विद हाइड्रोजन टू फॉर्म वाटर. रिएक्शन विद हाइड्रोजन व्हाट विल हैपन. कोवलेंट हाइड्राइड्स विल फॉर्म. क्वेश्चन में भी आस्क गिव एग्जांपल ऑफ कोवलेंट हाइड्राइड. मींस यू कैन गिव एग्जांपल ऑफ नॉन मेटल विद हाइड्रोजन एंड हेंस कोवलेंट हाइड्राइड विल फॉर्म. नेक्स्ट इज रिएक्शन विद एसिड. नॉन मेटल्स नेवर रिएक्ट विद एसिड. नॉन मेटल प्लस एसिड देयर विल बी नो रिएक्शन. नॉन मेटल्स आर इनर्ट टू एसिड. नो रिएक्शन. रिएक्शन विद वाटर अगेन no reaction. So what we have learned, non-metals are inert to acid and water. There will be no chemical interaction between non-metal and acid and as well as water. These are the selected and few properties of non-metals. Non-metals are less reactive than metals. Right? In next lecture we will understand the ionic compounds and covalent compounds. Thank you.